This video covers Blood Brothers from page 51 onwards. This is the section where Lyons family arrive in the country. So the section begins. Edward says goodbye. Mr. Lyons says, "Well, Edward, do you like it here?" Notice here the Rectian unreality, the way that simultaneously the stage has travelled from Johnston's house to Lyons' new home in the country, breaks the tragic unity of place. This is Russell with his alienation, making sure that we, the audience, do not identify with the characters, do not forget that this is an illusion, that this is a piece of theatre, emphasises this theatricality, and that's what we see here. So it continues. Edward enthusiastically says, "It's very nice." Mrs. Lyons says, "Oh, look, Edward, look at those trees and those cows. Oh, Edward, you're going to like it so much out here, aren't you?" And see the tag question, see the doubt. She is his mother, or she thinks, well, she tells that she is his mother, but she doesn't have that same instinctive relationship. The tag question shows her insecurity with the relationship, reminds us of her guilt. It's significant that even now they've just moved, she was hoping that it was going to represent a move away from the consequences of her actions, this geographical move, this move in space, but as we've seen here already, my language, her guilt follows her. Edward says, "Yes, are you feeling better now, Mummy?" Again, he can't see it, he has to ask the distance between them. Mrs. Lyons replies, "It was better now, darling. Oh, Edward, look, look at those bows. Look at that lovely black and white one." And of course, we can see that that black and white bird would be a magpie, and we all know our nursery rhymes, one for sorrow. That's the superstition there. So of course, scripture, it foreshadows towards the end of the play. It's trying to go, because of course, thanks to the prologue, we know the end of the play, and then the tableau as well. But it's also further evidence of superstition here. Now, towards the end of the Lyons' time in Locally itself, we saw Mrs. Lyons falling prey to superstition when she, Mr. Lyons put a pair of Edward's shoes on the table. The fact that she was now in a moment about to deny it, in a second when she said, "Edward, I think we can forget the silly things that Mickey said," I think shows us that she's trying to move away from that. But, as we of course remember, as the play continues on, she falls back prey to those same superstitions. Anyway, let's continue. So Mr. Lyons says, "Edward, that's just a stupid superstition." "Edward, it's not. Mickey told me." Mrs. Lyons says, "Edward, I think we can forget the silly things that Mickey said." Of course, look at that there. I think she's hedging, that's the technical term, hedging, and then that she's not certain. That's ironic because we know that the influence of Mickey won't be so easily thrown up. Now, of course, others. She tries to dismiss it. Think about some of the language that she uses, things like silly things. That adjective there, notice how Edward continues to be treated in a childlike way. That would be important later on when Mickey accuses Edward of being still a kid. Let's continue. So, Edward says, "I'm going outside. I want to read," and he exits. Mr. Lyons corrects his wife and says, "Children take time to adapt to their surroundings. But by writing away in a few days, he won't even remember he went to live somewhere else." Mrs. Lyons forces a smile and allows herself to be led inside by her husband. Mickey rings the doorbell of Edward's old house. A woman answers the door. Now again, this Rectian has a flawed use of space to symbolize different spaces almost simultaneously. Very much an evidence here. Because the stage has gone from outside Mickey's house to the Lyons' old house to Mickey outside the Lyons' old house in the space of a matter of seconds, a matter of a few lines of the play. And the old man answers, "No, If an idea, when an edit, and if that edit doesn't work on me, the idea is fine working on the woman. Okay. We have to start finding out where exactly people make you go here. Require some drivers who learn this without Eddie. There is a sort of gap on the drive that they can't even begin to rationalize. The law, right? Because if you go, it's short, then maybe because he can't, at the moment, he can't see that. Anyway, continues on. The law says goodbye. The law says,
I'm not